Nicely done. Blow it up. Blow it up.
Never a dull moment here at the White House, especially on Science Fair Day. These kids are about to get swarmed by the media, like they're like the Rolling Stones. Who they obviously don't know who the Rolling Stones are, but like Katy Perry, they're about to get swarmed like Katy Perry. This is like your science fair in middle school, but on steroids and with snipers on the roof.
Some of the best moments that I've had as president have involved science and our annual science fair.
So the president has been pushing for the last 6 years for kids, especially young girls and minorities, to really excel in STEM, science, technology, engineering, math.
That's outstanding. How long did it take you guys to put this all together?
The methods that we've used to teach have been really inadequate to teach the breadth of students that we have.
This is a list of all the participants in the White House Science Fair. Cell phone recognition, neuropathy study. These kids are like less than 18 years old, and they're working on all these incredible things.
Here we see a chicken in its unnatural habitat.
The chicken was part of one girl's science project, and she was looking at the ways that eggs develop.
I found that the Rhode Island Reds were the most profitable to raise for my business.
One girl developed a new assay or test for Ebola that is much, much less expensive than the test that's commonly used. And that's just amazing. She was, I believe, 12 years old. We've seen robots all along, but the level of the robots, like this one here, an underwater robot, I mean, that's beyond anything I've seen so far at the science fair.
We've been doing this for 6 years, so if you think about it, if there were any high school seniors who participated in 2010, they're probably a couple years out of college now. I mean, has the White House kind of kept up with any of those students?
One that I think really stands out for a lot of us is Alana Simon. The president said hello to her in the middle of his speech today.
Who studied her own cancer and started coming up with some cures. I remember meeting you last year. How's Harvard going?
Of course, over its 6 years, it's affected many, many people.
And it's affected you.
And it's affected me. The new generation is so committed to helping the world.